This is Tracy from Gift Basket Appeal, and today we're going to be decorating this wine bottle, and we're going to be using these beautiful Dollar Tree napkins. So, let's get started. I really fell in love with the colors of these napkins, with the green, the soft green, and then the pink and the purple. And then in the background, just a slight beige. I really fell in love with this. So I'm hoping this really turns out nice. I'm going to be Mod Podging it to our bottle. And then I found some other things that I wanted to use. I found this yarn, of course, that was already in my stash. I'm going to be painting our bottle white to begin with. I'm going to somehow incorporate these butterflies into the bouquet that I want to go inside of the bottle. And they all kind of blend in to bring all the colors together. And then somehow I want to use these stickers that I found at Dollar Tree. And these have the really nice colors that are in this napkin. So we'll see how this goes. Okay, so the first thing you want to do is paint your bottle. And for this wine bottle, I removed the labels by soaking it in warm water for about 30 minutes. And when once the label became soft, I was able to just peel it right off, at least for this bottle. So I'm just using a foam brush. And let me just show you which paint I'm using. It's the white indoor gloss paint, and it's from Apple Barrel, and you can get these at Walmart. Okay, so normally before I Mod Podge, I'm putting on some white paint, and this is because I want my napkins, the color of my napkins, to really be vibrant and stand out. So if I paint the background white, it should stand out. Actually, I am going to wipe this part off because I actually want this to be covered with my yarn. So I'm just going to wipe that off a little bit. So I'm going up to about here. It doesn't have to be real even, but I want to go to about there. And I probably could have left it on since it was going to be covered, but we'll see how this goes. Hopefully something in this video will inspire you to create your own. Whether it's just a simple technique as painting the bottle or using a napkin to Mod Podge some kind of container. So I always look to inspire, even if it's just one thing that you saw me do in my videos. And this paint is going on pretty good. And so I'm going to let it dry in between coats. I'm going to do two coats on this. I'm going to let it dry, and I'm going to put on another coat and let that dry. And I usually let it dry for about 15 to 20 minutes, but this is a glossy paint, so I'm not really sure, but I will post that drying time below. Okay, so the first coat is done. And I am going to let this dry. I'm going to add another coat. I'm going to let that dry, and then we'll come back and we'll start to do some Mod Podge. Okay, so our wine bottle is all dry. I put the two coats of acrylic paint on there, and it has a nice little shine to it. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to start the process of putting on the Mod Podge. Before I do that, I want to go ahead and take a look at these napkins. And it looks like, actually it's upside down. So I'm gonna cut right across the middle there. And I think I'll be using two napkins. I'm not sure, but it looks like I'm gonna have to use two napkins. Let me just see something here. Just want to see how much this would measure around. Yeah, so I'm going to have to use more than one of these. But look at those colors and how pretty they are. I am really, really liking this. So I'm just going to cut it right down the center here. That way we have it all together. It just seems a little bit easier to just cut all my little pieces in advance here. Oh, I could have left it folded and cut it also. That's okay. I'm just gonna have all my little pieces, and I may have to cut it a little bit and fit it in, but I'm really loving the whole process of doing this. Now this is a two-ply napkin, so once I cut it, it actually is easy to separate. And I think you can also wet your fingers and then just kind of rub the section of it and then pull it apart as well. Okay, pull this apart. And that will, when you pull it apart like that, it helps with less wrinkling or bubbling up underneath. I've done it with it before and it came out fine, but this time I want to just pull it apart. I just like the better look, and it's just less wrinkles. I'm going to go ahead and do this one for right now too, just to get a head start here. My dog is here in the room with me while I'm recording. His name is Cinnamon, but I call him Gooby. That's his pet name for me. He looks like a Gooby. My daughter's named him Cinnamon, but he loves to sit in the craft room with me. And he's, most of the time he's quiet, but every so often he likes to make his little noise. I think he likes to hear my voice too, as many of you have said also. Okay, so what we're going to do is, I'm just going to take this away because I don't really need this. I'm going to go ahead and start at the top there, because I want to make sure that these come out pretty even, and I may have to overlap it just a little bit. Let's see. And if it does have to overlap, I'm okay with that. And I think what I'm gonna do is, just wanna make sure that I have enough. Yep, I'm gonna just overlap them because I only want this to come around to the top of here. I don't really want it to go onto here because I'm gonna take my yarn and cover this with the yarn. So we got a lot of stuff going on with this bottle. Okay, so I'm gonna start with the bottom part first. And for me, it's just easier for me to do this in sections and then apply the napkin. Okay, and I just want to make sure it's lined up okay. So So right now I'm just placing it gently. Make sure you can see that. So I'm applying Mod Podge and then just taking a section and folding it over. I think it's initially just getting it started. It's a little bit more challenging. But I am loving the way this looks already. You just gotta be very careful when you're pulling this. And I really like using the white coat of paint underneath this because the colors really do stand out. So for those of you that's made that suggestion about using the white paint underneath the napkin to make the colors really pop and stay vibrant, thank you so much. I'm listening and learning. Because, of course, crafting is all about sharing ideas. Okay, so I'm going to lay that on there. And I'm really liking the way this looks. I really hope you can really see that on camera. And just some advice, make sure your hands are not touching the napkins because your hands, for some reason, like if you're holding it down here, your hands will actually end up making the napkin rip or tear. Okay, and so I have to find a piece to go in here too. So let's see. See if I can cut a piece here. These Dollar Tree napkins are just absolutely gorgeous. So whenever I go in there, I'm going to be over in that napkin section at Dollar Tree. So what I'm doing is I'm just trying to measure this out so that I can just kind of close up this part right here. And if it overlaps a little bit, it's okay. But I was kind of trying to be precise when I did my little cutting here. Almost forgot to pull that off. And I'm going to go ahead and cut another piece off of here just so I have it ready for the next row. And you see, I'm not measuring anything. I'm just going with the flow here. Okay. All right, so we have our pieces. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish off this part right here. I'm going to overlap just a little bit on my napkin there. Just want to make sure you can see that. Okay, and now a suggestion was made that when you're trying to smooth out your napkin, in order for it not to rip, take some Saran wrap and use the Saran wrap to smooth out the wrinkles. So this is my first time trying this. They said if you use your hands will rip the napkin. But if you use Saran wrap, the Saran wrap won't stick and it won't rip your napkin. So I'm not doing this really hard. But guess what? Another great suggestion. I'm actually able to smooth out some of the wrinkles on here. Just be careful, because you see I just tore that little piece right there. So just be gentle. But I am really liking this. Really does be using your hands. Yeah, so I can smooth out any bubbles that might be under there. So thank you, thank you, thank you for whoever sent that suggestion. I really appreciate you mentioning that. So, I am really loving that. Look at that. So now we got to do our top part up here. And I'm just taking this in sections. I just feel like it's easier for me to manage. So I'm going to start over here because I started before right in the same section. Oops. So I want to start, I want to begin at the same place as I did this bottom part. This is so much fun. If you haven't tried any of the Mod Podging, if that's a word, Mod Podging, you should really try it. It's really fun and it's a nice way to upcycle. Okay, so I'm going to be starting right around here. And I'm going to overlap, and that's okay. I'm okay with overlapping a little bit on there. And so as I place it, I'm kind of stretching it out, getting that first start on there. And then it actually just hugs that Mod Podge really good. Okay, and I'm just applying that on, pulling as I go, and that's adhering really nice. And I'm going to just smooth this. Oops, see, I made a little bit of a mistake there. See that? That's okay though. I'm going to probably cover that up by taking a little piece of this and putting it in that area. See, I got some purple here. And I'll do a little patchwork, okay. Right in there. It's like putting a Band-Aid over a cut. And there we go. And I'm just going to keep going. So just be gentle. That's my advice to you. So I'll make all the mistakes in my video so you don't have to. How's that? Okay. And so I'm just kind of putting in this last piece. And then I'll come back and show you what it looks like. Okay, I want to show you what this looks like. I am really, really loving this. And using that whole smoothing out technique with the Saran Wrap, that is really working. So all I did was I put some Mod Podge. I had a little bit that was just kind of sticking up. And I just took my Mod Podge and just put some along here. And then I smoothed the napkin all the way up so that it's laying straight. Now, it's okay that it's uneven around this area here, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some yarn. That's where this will come in. I'm going to use my yarn and I'm going to wind it around the top part of this. And you've probably seen me do that before in other videos, but I'm going to start it off just to show you how I start it, and then I'll just go ahead and finish it off so you don't have to see me do the whole thing. And I'm using Mod Podge to adhere it to my bottle, to adhere the yarn to the bottle. So I start at the top and then I work my way all the way down. It's just easier that way. I'm just putting some on here. And the yarn is really good when you're trying to adhere it to glass. I've never had a problem with it. Just starting it is at the tip top of this bottle, and then I'm just going to work my way around. And I'm just pulling it up since I want it to be really close. And I like the fact this has a little bit of purple in it and a little bit of sparkle. So I'm just winding it around. And so as I go, I just add more Mod Podge to it. And then I just keep on going. And these bottles make really nice gifts. My sister has a bunch of my bottle creations all over her house, so she's been saving some wine bottles for me. And so as I go along, I just kind of bring it up so it's nice and tight and there's nothing showing through. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and finish this off and then I'll come back and show you what it looks like. Okay, so I went ahead and covered that top part with the yarn. And so here's what it looks like. Loving that transition on there. Kind of breaks it up a little bit. But I'm still not done yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put another coat of Mod Podge on here because I need it to have a little bit of a shine and some protection on it. I'm going to put some Mod Podge on, let it dry, and then I usually like to do two coats. And then I'll show you what the next step is, because we're going to be adding some of these stickers. Okay, so I went ahead and put on two coats of Mod Podge, and you can see that shine on there. It's still drying a little bit. I would actually give it 24 hours to really dry, 24 hours plus. But while that's still drying, I'm going to show you what I'm going to do around this the neck of the bottle. I'm going to take these stickers, and you can just use one of the other glues. I'm going to go ahead and just use my glue gun. I'm just going to put a little dot on there, and then I figure I want to put some type of maybe the purple and the pink color just to tie everything in. And you don't have to do this. And all I'm doing is I'm going to put it right along this area right here. Okay, so I started off using the glue gun and then I decided to switch up a little bit. And I'm just going to use this tacky glue. And you don't have to do this. I just wanted to see what it would look like. So I'm going to show you and then you can decide whether you want to use it or not. So I'm just lining them up basically. And I'm just alternating it. I'm really loving these colors though, that's for sure. And the tacky glue will dry clear, that's why I like it. You don't need to use a lot either on there. Looks like I'll be going back to get more of these from Dollar Tree. Good way to enhance your projects. Okay, I'm just going to go ahead all the way around. I think you get the gist of it. That's what it looks like so far. I just wanted to have something to tie in the color down here, because I thought this had a little bit too much purple in it. And I wanted to lighten it up a little bit by enhancing using some of the colors from here. Okay, so let me give you a good look at it. What I did was I took some of those stickers and I just put them all around my bottle, just at different points. Thought that would be pretty to add just a little bit of sparkle to it. I'm really liking those stickers. And then there it is right along the neck there. And then another thing you can do if you didn't want to leave it like this, I see flowers in this. So I had gotten these cattails from Dollar Tree, which has a little bit of the green in it. Look how pretty that is. And also found a bunch of lilacs, which I thought would be pretty. And so you can just take those and add them. Just cut a few off and just add them to your bottle. And so you can add a big bouquet, a small bouquet. You can put a bunch of these in here. You can also, look at this butterfly, which goes really well also with this. It's like a pink butterfly. Look how pretty that is. And it has a little pin on it. So you can either stick it somewhere in here, maybe tie in a little bit of pink, you can see that, just to add to it. And I will post some pictures, or you can take this pin off. It's removable, what it looks like. Well, you can snip it off and you can put it somewhere along your bottle. Just giving you different options of things that you can do with this. For now, I'm just gonna put mine up here. Just let it lay there, but you might see it somewhere down here. I think I kind of like it, like right down here, maybe off to the side. Take off the pin and just hot glue it right on that yarn part. Kind of liking that. So just giving you different options. I also wanted to show you another bottle. This is a smaller one. And so I was working with this one also while creating the other one. And look how adorable that is. It's this much smaller bottle. Yep, and that napkin just looks great. No one would know it's a Dollar Tree napkin. So I hope you like this project. I hope you got some inspiration from it. Thank you so much for joining me on this fun crafting journey. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so. Leave a comment below. Let me know if you would put the butterfly into the bouquet or just put it somewhere on the bottle. I kind of like it both ways, but I'm kind of feeling it like on that bottle there. Thanks for joining me. Bye.